Good morning. My name is Michael Bisk, and I am with the University of Illinois Extension, Master Gardeners from Perry County, Illinois. And I am here to talk to you and identify the Eastern White Pine tree, also known as a Christmas tree.
Beginning with British colonists, the Eastern White Pine has proven to be one of the most important and most desirable species of North America. It is truly a magnificent tree, reaching heights of 80 feet or more at maturity, with a diameter of 2 to 3 feet round. The White Pine is considered to be the largest pine in the United States. Part of the history of the White Pine begins back in colonial times. White pines above 24 inches in diameter were reserved for England to be used as ship masts. These trees were identified by blazing a broad arrow on the trunk. Because of the colonists' general dislike of British rule, this broad arrow policy was one more source of friction between the two. Until about 1890, white pine was considered the species of choice for most commercial uses in building and construction. The Eastern white pine have blush green to silver green in color needles and are regularly arranged in bundles of five. Needles are 2.5 to 5 inches long, usually shed or drop off at the end of the second growing season. Both male and female flowers, which are called cones, occur on the same tree, with pollination occurring in the spring. Cones are 48 inches in length, usually slightly curved, and mature at the end of the second season. Cone scales are rather thin and never have prickles. Cones also release a fragrant, sticky resin. Bark on young trunks of the Eastern white pine and branches that are smooth and tends to be greenish brown in color. On older trunks, the bark becomes dark gray and shallow and has a crackling or splitting effect on the bark. White pine is intermediate in shade tolerance, and it is found on many different sites, including rocky ridges and wet sphagnum bogs. But best development is on moist, sandy loam soils, particularly in the southern United States and Florida. Extensive logging has destroyed most of the original pine forest, but the species is aggressive in reproducing itself and may be found throughout its original range. Due to its desirability and relative ease of nursery production, it has also been a major species for reforestation in the northeastern United States and Canada. The Christmas tree, which is the white pine, was introduced in the United States by German settlers in the early 1800s. The first written record of a decorated Christmas tree was from Northern Europe in 1510. Men of local merchants decorated a tree with artificial roses, considered to be a symbol for the Virgin Mary. For Christmas trees, sheared trees are preferred, although people feel shearing results in trees too dense for larger ornaments. Needle retention is good to excellent, and the white pine has very little aroma, but conversely is reported to result in fewer allergic reactions than do some of the more aromatic species. To produce a 6-foot tree, it requires 6 to 8 years of growth on good sites. While the white pine has a broad geographic range, growing from Newfoundland to Manitoba in Canada, through the northern United States to northern and eastern Ohio, and the southward along the Appalachian Mountains to northern Georgia and South Carolina. It can be found from sea level in its northern range to 5,000 feet in the Appalachian Mountains. Propagation of white pine is mostly done by seed, although the white pine species graft is easily done to reproduce. About 70 varieties have been developed for commercial use. The white pine has historically been one of the most valuable lumber trees. It has soft, light wood, which warps less than many other species. The wood is adapted to a variety of uses to include cabinets, interior finish, and carving. Early Native Americans used the inner bark as food, with colonists using the inner bark as an ingredient in cough remedies. Seeds are eaten by birds. Rabbits may eat the bark of young trees, as may porcupines.